नमस्ते, दिस इज रमेश नायडू फ्रॉम टारगेट स्कूल। टुडे टॉपिक सर्किल्स पार्ट वन फॉर नाइन्थ क्लास स्टूडेंट्स, राइट। इन दिस पार्ट वन वी डिस्कस अबाउट सर्किल डेफिनेशन, रेडियस, डायमीटर, कार्ड एंड सेगमेंट्स लाइक दैट टर्म्स, राइट। सी सर्किल्स पार्ट वन फॉर नाइन्थ क्लास स्टूडेंट्स। First, what is the definition of circle, right? So, in our daily life, we have seen round shape like tubes, tires, and plates like that, right? So, such a type of round shapes are called circles, right? So, what is the definition of circle? Observe carefully. Circle is a plane figure, right? So, in a plane. It is fixed point, right? So here P is fixed point. In a plane, P is fixed point, and the collection of all points which are equidistant from this fixed point. So from P to the collection of all points which are equidistant from fixed point, that is P. See. The collection of all points from a fixed point is called a circle, right? So this is called a circle. So once again, listen. The collection of all points which are equidistant from a fixed point is called a circle, right? Here the fixed point is called the center of the circle, right? Here the fixed point is called the center of the circle, right? Here fixed point P is called the center of the circle, and the equal distance from P to any point on the circle. So let A is any point on the circle. So it is a fixed distance, that is equal distance. So from P to any point on the circle, PA is called the radius of the circle, right? And the equal distance that is PA is called the radius of the circle. Right? So once again, listen. Here P is center of the circle. P is center and PA is radius. Another definition also there. So what is another definition? The locus of points which are equidistant from a fixed point is called a circle. That is another definition, right? So once again, listen. A collection of all points in a plane which are equidistant from a fixed point is called a circle, right? Here the fixed point is called the center of the circle, and the equal distance from fixed point from center to any point on the circle is called the radius, right? So now one small note: how many radii is the plural of radius, right? How many radii we can draw to a circle? So PA is radius, denoted with R. It is denoted with R. R means radius, right? And it is also radius like this. So how many radii we can draw to a circle means, we can draw infinite radii we can draw infinite radii to a circle, right? Number of radii means the plural of radius. Radius is singular, radii means plural, right? Number of radii to a circle is dash. So how many radii we can draw to a circle? Many, infinitely many, right? Many, right? So this is the definition of circle. So go for next definition, that is the chord of a circle. Observe carefully. Chord of a circle. So what is the definition of chord? So a circle with center O, right? A circle with center O, and take any two points on the circle. It is the point A and it is the point B, right? So AB are two points on the circle, right? If we join AB, it divides the circle into two parts, right? Two segments. It is minor segment, it is major segment, right? So in this AB is line segment joining two points on the circle. So it is called chord of the circle, right? So chord is a line segment joining two points on the circle. It is called the chord of the circle, right? Here AB is one chord. Is a chord, right? So once again, listen. What is the chord of the circle? A line segment joining two points on a circle is called chord of the circle, right? So chord, it is a line segment joining two points on the circle, right? Here AB is a chord. This chord divides the circle into two parts. So it is one part and it is another part, right? So this part look like a small and this part look like large. So this part is called a minor segment. So it is called a minor segment. Right? And it is called a major segment. Right? So every chord divides the circle into two parts. So in that, if it is small, it is called a minor segment. If it is large, that is called a major segment. Right? So how many chords we can draw to a circle? See? We can draw many chords. So it is AB next to PQ like this. We can draw many chords. Right? Like this. So number of chords can draw to a circle means many, infinitely many chords. Right? So that is very important bit. Number of chords we can draw to a circle dash. How many? Many, infinitely many. Right? Many chords. Next to definition, diameter. What is the definition of diameter? Diameter of a circle. Observe carefully. Yes. If a chord passes through center of the circle, then that is called the diameter of the circle. See? It is a circle with center O and AB is called. It passes through center of the circle, right? So if a chord passes through center of the circle, then the chord is called diameter of the circle. So AB is diameter. And one more, here the OB is, it is radius, and OA also radius, right? So OB is equal to, OA is equal to radius. And what is diameter? Diameter denoted with D. Then D is equal to R plus R, means OA plus OB. OA plus OB, that is equal to R plus R, that is equal to 2R. See, observe carefully. Here the diameter is twice the radius of the circle. Diameter D is equal to 2 times the radius of the circle, right? And then R is equal to, radius is equal to half of diameter. See, AB is diameter, half of diameter is radius, and diameter is R plus R, that is 2R. 2 times the radius of radius, right? So, what is the definition of diameter? If a chord passes through center of the circle, then that is called, diameter of the circle. Right? So if a chord passes through the center of a circle, then that is called diameter of the circle. So here diameter denoted with D, right? So diameter denoted with D. D is equal to R plus R, 2R. Then R is equal to radius, R is equal to half of diameter, D by 2, right? And one more. Here diameter is largest chord to the circle, right? So in any circle, what is the largest chord means? That is diameter. It is largest chord. So it is smallest chord, then AB, right? It is very small, right? And it is also smaller chord, then AB, small. It is also small lines. But of all chords, which is largest chord? AB is largest chord, right? So the largest chord of a circle is diameter, right? So very interesting bit. What is the largest chord? Diameter. Here diameter is largest chord. Right? So it is very very important for bit. So once again listen. How many chords we can draw to a circle? Many. Infinitely many chords we can draw to a circle. Right? Next. What is the largest chord? Largest chord is diameter. Right? So how many diameters we can draw to a circle? We can draw many diameters. Here AB is diameter. So it is also diameter. Right? If any chord passes through center of the circle, that is called diameter. So it is also diameter. Right? So in this way, we can draw many diameters, can draw to a circle, right? See, once again, listen, how many radii we can draw to a circle? Many. How many diameters we can draw to a circle? Many. How many chords we can draw to a circle? Many. Right? Next, go for semicircle. Semicircle means a half circle, right? Diameter divides a circle into two parts. Here each part is called semicircle, right? Observe carefully. A circle with center O and diameter. AB is diameter. So diameter, it is a chord passes through center, that is called diameter. So here AB is diameter. This diameter divides the full circle into two parts. So it is one part and it is also one part. So here each part, this part is called a semicircle, right? So the part look like this. So it is center O, AB is its diameter. It is called a semicircle, right? Semi means a half circle. So what is the area of a total circle? We know very well, area of circle, complete circle. Area of circle is equal to pi r square, right? That is area of circle. And what is the circumference of circle? Means the perimeter of circle. Perimeter. Perimeter of circle denoted with the C. C means circumference. Circumference or perimeter. Perimeter C is equal to. So perimeter of circle means the length of circle is 2 pi r, right? So that is area of circle, pi r square when given radius. And the perimeter of circle C is equal to 2 pi r, right? And what is the area of a semicircle? Area of semicircle. Area of semicircle. Area of full circle is pi r square. Semicircle means pi r square by 2, right? Pi r square by 2, right? And what is the circumference of semicircle? Circumference of semicircle means perimeter of semicircle. Perimeter of semicircle. See, observe carefully. The total circumference is 2 pi r. Then a half means half from here to here is pi r. It is radius r, r, right? So total circumference of circle is 2 pi r. Then half arc is pi r, right? R plus pi r plus r, right? So r plus r, 2r plus pi r. 2r plus pi r, right? So that is the perimeter of a semicircle. Perimeter of semicircle is 2r plus pi r, right? So by taking r common, r of 2 plus pi, or it can be simplified as like this, 2 plus pi value is 22 by 7, it is nearer value. That is equal to 7 is a 14 plus 22, 36 r into 36 by 7, right? That is equal to 36 r by 7. So this is a circumference of a semicircle. Circumference of semicircle is 36 r by 7, right? Next, arc of a circle. So what is the definition of arc? A-R-C. Read as the arc, right? So, a circle with center O. It is a circle with center O. And take any two points on the circle. So it is A and it is B, right? The distance between these two points is called an arc, right? So arc, it is a part of circle. It is a part of circle in between any two points, right? So arc means a part of circle in between two points on circle is called an arc, right? The part between any two points on the circle is called an arc, right? So in this circle, AB is from here to here. It is called an arc. It is denoted with AB arc. See, we have to draw like this, AB arc, right? So in the total circle, so this arc is small than remaining arc, right? So it is small. So it is called minor arc, right? So AB is minor arc. It is called minor arc. Right? So what is the remaining part? The remaining part is like this. Say X here. The remaining part from here to here. It is remaining part. See? The remaining part, it is very larger than this, right? So the remaining part, the remaining arc is called a major arc. It can be written as A, X, B. See, A, X, B. Draw like this. It is called a major arc. Right? It is minor arc and it is major arc, right? Next, go for next definition. What is a segment? So, what is the segment of a circle? Observe carefully. If a chord, AB is chord. If a chord divides the circle in two parts, right? So, in this, the two parts are called segments of the circle, right? So, in this, it is minor segment, it is major segment, right? It is minor segment. And it is major segment. Right? So, what is the definition of segment? Yes, segment. See, observe carefully. The area enclosed by a chord and an arc. See, it is chord and an arc. This is called a segment, right? And here also, it is look like small, so it is called a minor segment. It is called a major segment. See, the area enclosed by a chord and an arc is called a segment of a circle. So it is also one of the part of circle, right? So what is major segment? What is minor segment? So minor segment means the area enclosed by a chord and an arc is called minor segment, right? And the area enclosed by major arc and a chord is called a major segment, right? That is a segment of a circle definition, right? Next definition, congruent circles. Congruent means if two circles have same radii, means the radius is the same, right? Look like the same shape and the same size are called congruent circles. If two circles have same radius, then they are called congruent circles, right? Congruent circles have same radius. So the circles with the same radius are called congruent circles. See, It is a circle with radius 3 centimeters, right? And another circle, it is also with radius 3 centimeters. See, here both circles have same radius, 3 centimeters, 3 centimeters, right? So then these two circles are called congruent circles, right? So when two circles are congruent, if the radius of circles is the same, then they are called congruent circles, right? Next, go for concentric circles. Concentric circles means circles, two or more circles with different radius, different radii, but they have only common center, then they are called concentric circles. See, circles with the same center, here center is the same. Circles with the same center but different radii are called concentric circles. See, it is a center O. With center O, it is the first circle and the next circle and next circle. See, so all the circles have same center, right? But radii is different. It is R1 and it is R2 and it is R3, right? So the circles with the same center and different radii are called concentric circles. Here these three circles have common center, right? That is O, but the radius is different, right? So congruent circles and concentric circles. In congruent circles, radii is same. In concentric circles, center is same, right? Keep in mind. So go for next definition, sector. So what is the definition of sector? Observe carefully. A circle with center O, right? And O is radius and OB also radius, right? And AB is an arc, see? So this shape is called sector of the circle, right? So observe carefully. So what is the definition of sector? The area, the region enclosed by an arc, enclosed by an arc and two radii, and two radii joining the center to the end points of arc is called a sector, right? So this is the sector. O, A, B is a sector, right? So objectively, OA is radius and OB also radius and AB is an arc, right? So it is plain figure. This region enclosed by an arc and two radii, right? Joining the center of the circle and two end points of arc is called a sector, right? It is called a sector. So in this angle O is angle of sector denoted with theta, right? And it is length of arc, say L. It is radius, it is also radius, right? So this is the sector which is enclosed by minor arc and two radii. So it is called a minor sector. It is called a minor sector. So if it is a small means minor sector, if it is large means major sector, right? So what about its corresponding sector? So it is a large sector, right? It is called a major sector. So it is also OAB is minor sector and OAXB is major sector. It is called major sector. See, minor sector is enclosed by minor arc and two radii, right? And major sector enclosed by major arc and two radii, right? That is called a major sector, right? And what is the area of sector? Area of a sector A is equal to formula. So it is angle of sector theta by 360 into pi r square, right? So this is the area of sector formula, theta by 360 into pi r square, right? The total area of circle is pi r square. So in this, what is the area of a minor sector? Means suppose if it is theta angle, theta if the angle is theta, then what is its area? So theta angle in total 360, theta by 360 into pi r square, right? So if it is theta, then what about remaining angle? 360 minus theta, right? So because in circle at center the total angle is 360, if it is theta, means what about remaining is 360 minus theta. Okay, so angle at center in circle is 360 degrees, right?